Chris, lovely to have you here. Thank you so much.
It's beer.
Now, couldn't help noticing that you were in a children's programme called Me Too.
How was it?
What was it like working with old Harvey W. and Louis C.K.?
It was sticky. 150 episodes in 9 months, which gives you some idea of the quality of the programming. My daughter, when she was kind of that age, my wife tried showing it to her and she didn't like it at all. She didn't. She was like, that's not Dada.
She didn't believe that it was you on the show?
No, I looked young and happy.
Let's start round one. First, the worst. This is the round where we ask our guests for a story of such bad behaviour it would even put the shits up Fritzel. Points for the worst. Jamali, my dear, would you be mother? Would you start it all off for us, please?
So I must have been about 10.
Right.
And we had this pond in the back of my garden. And I remember there was something went around where it killed all these frogs.
Oh, yeah.
So there was these frogs covered in, like, dead frogs everywhere. Ooh. And my mum said to my dad, she goes, that's it, get rid of it. I don't want it here, get rid of it. Then my dad's like, oh, for fuck's sake. So he's gone and he's took my toy case and he's took all the toys out. And it's like a plastic toy case and he's filled it up with water with the fish in it. And he's gone, all right, Jamali, get your shoes. So I put my shoes on. And as we're driving, my dad's like a really intense dude as well. So as we're driving, he's like, you know, life is suffering. And we've gone to the local park.
Yeah.
And my dad said, all right, be lookout. And I said, for what? And he goes, the gathers. So I'm looking out for the police. And I'm like, what's he doing? And he's gone to the lake and he's dumped exotic fish into the park lake. And then I read in the newspaper years later that there was something wrong with the ecosystem of the local park. Because someone's dumped fish in there.
Wow.
And it was my dad and I was lookout.
Oh.
And then, like, what I think is unforgivable is my dad did have a moral dilemma. He was like, oh, I shouldn't be doing this. I was like, go on, Dad, don't be a pussy. And he was like, I ain't no pussy. And that's why he did it.
I ruined my own ecosystem once by drinking too many WKDs and got thrush. Similar.
That was in Valentine's Park, wasn't it?
It was in Valentine's Park.
Valentine's Park in Ilford, which, yeah. Interestingly, that's where... Well, it's not that interesting, but it's where we used to film Bake Off. We did series two of Bake Off.
In Ilford?
In Ilford.
Are you mad, bruv? What are you doing in Ilford, bruv?
We did it!
Bruv, you were filming Bake Off in Ilford?
We had that prissy, poncy...
Well, you didn't have, like, a good budget or something, bruv.
No, the budge was a bit low.
What did you think of Ilford, though?
I really loved Ilford.
Man, you must have bought crack or something, bruv. That place...
I've got to make a confession, Jamali. I never left
that park area.
I never left the park area.
Yeah.
I didn't. I never went into Ilford.
Yeah, good.
Central. Thank you very much for that, Jamali. Right, Sarah, let it all out. What's your worst story? Come on.
So, I've been with my husband for 15 years. We wanted to go to the planetarium in London. We thought it would be romantic to look up at the stars.
Yeah.
But you have to... They make you go through Madame Tussauds. You can't just go to the planetarium and look at all the bunny stars. You have to go through all the waxworks and you have to go through the zigzag queue and it takes ages. And then we walked into the world leader's room.
Right.
And oddly, in that room, there was a waxwork of Hitler. And my husband said, for a laugh, should I have a photo with Hitler just for a laugh? And I was like, yeah, let's do that. So I had an old crappy flip phone.
Yeah.
And I stood in front of him and he had his arm around Hitler. And I took a photo and he said, are we done? Because it was uncomfortable, because it was weird. And then people started to come in the room. We went, because we'd been alone to that point, people started to come in the room and they started to look across at my husband with his arm around Hitler. And I just kept taking photos. And in the end, I had 9 perfect photos. And he was mortified that I'd made him stand for so long with
his everyone arm. Watching.
Yeah.
9, which, of course, in German is no perfect pictures.
We've been in Germany. No, not if only. Definitely not.
Chris, can we have your story, please?
I need to be quite vague about this so that I don't get any comebacks on this story. So, a long time ago in a galaxy far away, there was a house, and I lived there with some lads, and it was a shithole. To give you an idea, it had a shower in the kitchen. right? Which, and not a shower, the only shower was in the kitchen.
Oh, right? My God.
It had a hole in the wall halfway up. So if the floor was wet and you went in and you slipped, your leg would go through the hole and stick out the outside of the building. And so if everyone outside, they just see a leg halfway up the building, like there was some kind of glitch in the Matrix, right? The plumbing was so bad that if it rained more than slightly heavily, the sewage would explode out the toilet in the basement. And one of my mates I was living with woke up to find a turd floating past his bed one morning. So it was horrific. It was horrific. And we badgered the guy to fix up the things. He did absolutely nothing. So we moved out early and we said to him, listen, don't want any hassle. Keep the deposit. So one day, me and my mate, we've had a few beers. We're walking past the house during the time that we're actually still paying for the place, but we're not living there anymore. And I've still got the key on my thing. I said, let's go in. And the cheeky bastard, he's had the place done up with our money during the time that we should have been in there.
Wow.
Even though he wouldn't fix the place when we were living there. He'd had the place painted, he'd had the place carpeted, he'd fixed the hole, but all the gear was still there. So me and my mate thought, well, let's give him a hand with the decorating. We opened the paint and we threw the paint around and, you know, put the oil-based gloss on a few of the walls and on the carpet, and I'll be honest, we fucked the place up a little bit. Do you know what? Like, I think part of this show is meant to be things that you feel bad about. But do you know what? I feel glad I'd done it. So there you go. Do I get double points for that?
That's the spirit. If you do manky deeds like that and you actually enjoy them, you are going to do very, very well on the show.
If you put a glory hole in the bathroom, you're supposed to then give a discount to the tenants, because that's what I do for my guys.
What is a glory hole?
You put your dick through it.
Oh!
Yeah.
Oh, sorry!
He's so innocent! He's so innocent!
Listen. Now, Lou, what are your feelings about these three utter douchebags? Come on, let's have a listen.
Well, I've written, Sarah's husband took a picky with a dicky, Jamali's dad killed some dishes with some fishes, and Chris was a squatter for what you gotta forgotta.
Nice, Lou. Can I just ask about the glory hole? When you've put the, you know, in there, what do you do?
Well, just flick the end. That's what they like, I think.
That's the sort of the excitement, isn't it? It's like, oh, what's going to happen?
Oh, because somebody's on the other side.
Yeah, somebody's on the
other side. Guys, you should have explained. I thought it was just a hole in the wall. It didn't lead anywhere.
You think that you can't do one for equality and slip your labia through? You absolutely can.
Presumably, as you get older, that gets easier.
Yes.
That's all rude stuff. Oh, I hope my mum's not watching. Mum, please don't watch. Anyway,
she knows what a glory hole is.
Listen.